break even and target operating income problem 3. Mango LLC sells its product for $60 and has variable costs of $30 per unit. The total fixed costs are $27,000. What will be the effect on the break-even point in units if variable cost increases by $10 due to an increase in the cost of direct materials? This question seems a little confusing, but I assure you it's actually pretty straightforward as long as you remember your contribution margin and break-even calculations. So what will be the effect on the break-even point if in units, so it wants to know in units, if variable costs increase by $10 due to an increase in the cost of direct materials? Well, just thinking about this, we know the contribution margin is sales minus variable costs. And we also know that to calculate the break-even point in units, the formula is going to be fixed costs plus your desired profit, which again for break-even will be zero as we've seen in previous problems. So that will be zero for break-even. We put that over the contribution margin per unit. Now, if we know contribution margin goes into this, the break-even calculation, and the variable costs increase, we know that's going to have an effect on the break-even in units. That means that this number is going to decrease. And if contribution margin decreases, then our break-even number in units is going to increase in order to break even. And that makes sense too, because you're looking at how many units it's going to cost to cover fixed costs. That's basically what we're doing here, because the fixed cost is a fixed amount. And the more variable costs, more items you sell, you're not only chipping away at variable costs, but you're also getting to that fixed cost. So if your variable costs increase, it's going to take more units to cover that fixed cost. So that makes sense. But the question here is, how many units does it actually increase by? So that's what we're focusing on. We know it's going to increase, but really by how many units? That is the focus. So let's go ahead and let's calculate that. The best way to do this is just plug and chug. Just do two separate calculations, one before, one with the before numbers, the original numbers, and then one after, one with the new increased variable cost numbers. So before versus after using the same formula. So let's start with our before calculation. We're going to take our numbers given to us. So Mango sells its product for $60 and has variable cost of $30 per unit, and the total fixed costs are $27,000. So again, break even in units, we take our fixed costs plus zero. So our fixed costs here are $27,000 plus zero. So we'll just keep that at $27,000. And we're going to divide that by the contribution margin per unit. We're told that sells for $60 per unit. And then the variable, that's right here, selling price is $60. And the variable cost is $30 per unit. So we can go ahead and we can calculate that. It's going to be $27,000 over $30 per unit. And that's going to equal 900 units. So 900 units to break even. $27,000 over $30 per unit, 900 units. That's the before picture. So the after picture with the increase in variable cost by $10, it's going to be pretty much the same calculation, just variable cost going to go up by $10. That's all that's going to happen. So plus $10. So $27,000 fixed cost stays the same, plus zero. So again, $27,000. And that's all going to be over the selling cost, which is still $60 per unit. Again, the original $60. And we're going to subtract away the variable costs. The variable costs, $30, but again, the problem after says increases variable cost by $10. So 30 plus 10 is 40. Getting ahead of myself there. So that's going to be $40. So now, after situation is $27,000 over $20. And we calculate that to break even, the number of units is going to be 1,350 units. So before break even, before the change, is 900 units, after is 1,350 units. And the question's asking, what will be the effect on the break even point in units if variable cost increases by $10 due to an increase in the cost of direct materials? Again, we start off the problem just thinking about it, and we know that when contribution margin goes down, which it did, it went from $30 in the bottom, right? We saw that here, to $20. We know that break even units will increase. So it went from 900 units to 1,350. The difference, the change. So we compare the before 900 units with the after 1,350 units. So we take 1,350 after minus 900 before. The change is 450 units. So that is the answer here. The answer is that the number of units to break even, the break even in units increases by 450. That is the answer. That is what we're looking for. Again, the idea is that if you know variable costs are going to go up, then that is going to increase the break-even in units required, because again, break-even is all about covering the fixed costs. Now, if sales go up, that's going to reduce. So think about it, right? You've got sales. If sales go up, it's going to be the opposite. Variable costs, it's going to increase. So that's the idea. Sales go up, break-even number of units is going to go down. The variable costs go up, because again, the idea is you're covering fixed costs. So with that, that's the idea. You see relationships here, very important formulas, and a really good question to learn these on.